Hey guys, no meme to start the episode off. Something so much better. So I did a live stream this weekend. It was on Saturday. Speaking of live stream, I mentioned it a lot this episode, and this was supposed to come out a lot sooner, but I got super busy with work, so I apologize. But something super monumental happened on that live stream. Here, just let me show you. Graham donated $55. He originally donated $5 and then came back with a 50 bomb. They said, keep up the awesome videos, man. I am in a welding school and I hope to make it as a welder one day. Cool to see someone in a similar field share MC interest. Hope you and everyone can follow your dreams and make things happen. Much love, brother. So be sure to leave some love down there in the comments for Graham. We actually made a little shrine here. It's not going to stay here. We're going to make a super better place than this. Once again, thank you so much, Graham. That literally means the world to me. Hey guys, Saigey here. Today's episode is kind of wonky. We ran a couple volts, we died a bit, and we made an Omega pickaxe. Emphasis on Omega. It's basically an atomic disassembler. I'll keep this intro short, and let's just get straight into the episode. And I'm super sorry for the drought in uploads. I got super busy with work, so I apologize about that. Hey guys. How's it going? There's a few things I want to do to start this episode off. Up first, I think we need to craft up a new magnet because mine's just about broken. Up next, there is a knowledge star over here in the black market, and as y'all know, last episode we smelted up a ton of those scavenger items and we have a ton of soul dust. So we have 177. How many will we get? We are now up to 608, so we're about halfway there. Oh, okay, now it's time to roll up the magnet. What are we gonna get? Oh, we got a common this time. That's not too bad with copiously, so that's pretty insane. And recipe? Moss, seagrass, iron, and bones. Moss, some iron, seagrass, and finally bones. I don't know about you guys, but I'm so ready to run a volt. But before we run a volt, there's one thing I want to add to this bubble blower. A few comments said that adding stasis to it lets you make temporary blocks to walk on, and I think that would be extremely overpowered in the vault. So let's add that to this and see exactly what they're talking about. I came up a few blocks, and now when I blow, oh my gosh, that is insane. Wait, can you... Oh my goodness, this is literally insane. This is going to be a game changer for when you're inside the vault. Now, if I take a few extra pieces of soap with me, can I refill it and it keeps stasis? Oh my goodness, it looks like it does. So let's grab an unbreaking book as well, just so it can last a bit longer. Never mind, you can't add unbreaking to it. That's a-okay, because we'll just go ahead and add that to our bamboo staff. So let's open up this portal, try to go for living chest, and get a couple of soul shards. Mainly because I want that knowledge star. Oh, this is a huge bummer. We got wild obelisk and a winter theme vault. Safe to say we're going to probably build this. And they're already coming. You know what? I forgot to make another compass, and check it out, an obelisk straight off the bat. Before we click that obelisk, let's test out this bubble wand once we come over here. Oh, that's pretty useful. Oh, a tier 2 strafe. Let's stay as far away from him as we can. And then here's what we'll do. We're going to go ahead and click this and then run down here and hopefully, okay, they all spawned above me. Yeah, let's start spamming this water before it's too late. And then get rid of these crossbow guys and the rest should be pretty easy. Okay, it's saying that there's 5 of them, but I'm only seeing this last one and the other one is not glowing, so it may be bugged. Oh, wait, never mind. There was 2 literally right here. Couldn't even see the other one. Yeah, but what we're going to do is only go for the obelisk and I really want to only go for living chest. Now, if we happen to see a coin pile along the lines, we may go ahead and go off track. I just gotta remember that this is a wild vault, so there are gonna be mobs in every single room. Well, like I said, if we did find a few coin piles, we'll go ahead and try to get them. And what the heck is hitting me? Oh, it's one of those wild mobs. Check out this POI. There's a nice little, like, dragon here guarding a couple of living chests, and I'm in frozen snow. Okay, now that we're out of that, let's go ahead and open up all these bad boys and hopefully get a couple more of that knowledge essence. How rude of me. I bet you guys can't even see. Let's put a few torches down. Oh, we got a mystery egg. Nice. Oh, and we completed a bounty. I forgot which one that even is. Yeah, there was so many living chests here. Now the search continues for more living chests. Ooh, what is that? Oh, wow, we got an epic plus idol. That's gonna be insane. I should probably heal. Oh, check it out, a couple more living boys. And you know what? Since they're visible, let's go ahead and get these gilded boys because we may get a few volt diamonds. No volt diamonds, but we did get a dreamstone. Refills my mana. Let me heal up first and then we'll use it. I was gonna mine those coin piles, but the storm rider ended up showing up. Okay, now that he's gone, now we can mine him up. Oh, you guys see what I'm seeing? I know this is a snowy vault, so yeah, it is an obelisk. Not sure if it's even worth doing it because we do need 5 of them in all. Yeah, gonna be kind of hard to complete this because we need 5 and we only have 15 minutes left, but let's risk it for the biscuit. Spam down that water, and then continue to cheese on to these guardians. Alright, here's the last one. That's all we need to do. One more guardian, and then we can start searching for the next one. Right after we get these coin piles. Okay, that was pretty lucky. It was in the very next room. Thankfully, this one only needs 3 of them. And... okay, yeah, nice. Okay, guys, you cannot make this up. The very next room. So, 3 rooms in a row is basically this room, and now this room. Why can't I get this lucky when I do live streams? Speaking of live streams, we're going to be going live on Saturday. 9 PM Central Standard Time. And don't worry if you can't make it because the VOD will be posted. Yeah, the infinite water burger is so overpowered for this. Oh, grants 4 bonus hearts for 2 minutes? Thank you. Now let's hope we can continue getting lucky with these little objectives. Oh my gosh, the last obelisk. Before we get all gung-ho with that, let's try to walk around here and see if we can find any more living chests. You know, this sword does give 83% more soul shards, so that might be pretty good. Oh my gosh, we found a living dungeon. You cannot make this luck up. I should probably break the spawner before I start talking about luck, because all I need is for one of those guys to go ahead and spawn on me and just completely one-shot me. Sorry, Stormy, but it has to be done. Well, let me put some water down and then go ahead and fight these last few guardians. There's no way I die, right? Right? Okay, nice. We completed the vault, so let's head back to the base and see what kind of loot we got. Remember, the main thing I'm needing is that knowledge essence, so I really didn't loot too many chests, only the living ones. I knew my luck would come to an end, because right now, my world is just constantly loading me in. I'm gonna give it a few minutes, and if it doesn't work, I guess I'm kind of screwed. Okay, wait a minute. Here we go. Here we go. 10k experience. How many chests did I end up getting? 22 living and a couple of wooden ones. I didn't think I actually looted that many. But we don't care about this. We care about that amazing chest or crate that we're about to get. Boy, oh boy, we're gonna set that down, clear out our bags, and then go open up that crate. Oh, I completely forgot we got that idol. And 2 mystery eggs, so that's always good. Oh, look at all the knowledge essence we got. I don't think it could have been any better than that. Okay, now moment of truth. Are we gonna get an artifact from here? No. But we got 13 volt diamonds, that is insane. We even got a sword. I doubt it's gonna beat the bamboo staff, but we'll see. What are we gonna get? A common sword and an epic idol. Oh wow, a legendary prefix? That's not bad, but the one that we have is a lot better, and this idol is 54% soul chance. So that mixed with our sword's gonna be a pretty good chance for souls. And we need a lot because we want to get this knowledge star so we can get just a bit closer to unlocking the power mod. I do want to go ahead and make up 2 repair cores because my boots and my chest plate are actually pretty decent. So I got 44% soul chance on the boots and then 45 on the chest plate. We're not going to use these just yet because currently I want to make a new helmet. I want to roll the helmet up and I want to get an Omega, which we did not get. Wait, okay, there it goes. And I want to get an Omega, which we did not get. That's decent, but nothing too crazy. While we're at it, let's go ahead and add unbreaking and feather falling to our... While we're at it, let's go ahead and add some unbreaking and feather falling to these boots. That should help out with damage in the vaults. And you know what? Our chest plate is pretty low, so we will go ahead and add a repair core to this right away. And since we added that repair core, I went ahead and bought an unbreaking 3 book for this chest plate, just to get a bit more life out of it. Recipe? Ooh, do I have enough tough for this? That is tough. We have 6. And the only way to get it is either through Britannia or killing one of these things, and I don't even want to go near this bad boy. So time to go mining. And after a bit of mining, we are now smooth sailing. Get it? Because smooth is the opposite of tough. No? Okay. I've been a dad for 2 months and I'm already using dad jokes. We are super close to unlocking the power mod. We just need 2 more knowledge stars worth of knowledge essence. Unless I can somehow manage to kill enough mobs to get them all. Whoa, what theme is this? Is this an alternate nether theme? Yeah, it looks like a Soul Sand Valley nether theme. I forgot the compass again. Oh, but I see some more Nate boys. Oh wow, we actually got a magnet from that. That's pretty sick. Yeah, sadly there was no anvils in this POI though. Oh my gosh, but you do know what there is? A couple living chests and the first of a few obelisks. Okay, this took a lot longer than it should have to actually get safe enough to fight these bosses. But now that it's somewhat safe, let's make it a bit safer. I did not mean to click that. Thankfully, there's only 3, so this shouldn't be too big of a problem. Yeah, those are already done for. I will say, having all these bone blocks around makes it pretty hard to find the living chest POIs. So these aren't living, but there are a couple of innate boys over here. I've got to say, I really love all these new POIs. Especially when they're living. Oh, that's cool. Catalyst Rag gets to spawn on these now. Or you know what? Maybe that's because we have Prismatic. Ooh, that's not a living chest, but that is an obelisk. Let's right click this and try to find a safe spot to get to. Oh no, we need water. Oh my gosh, my helmet just broke. This isn't gonna go. We gotta get rid of the crossbow guys. These guys do the most damage to us. Okay, and there's one last guy over here that I gotta get. He's like one shot. There he goes. Oh, I guess he was 2 shots. Yeah, I can't believe our helmet broke. Actually, I can because you guys are always telling me to put in breaking on my gear, and I never do. Wait, I just made a new helmet and I scrapped it because I thought it wasn't good enough. I should have definitely brought it in. Oh, hey, look, a little green dragon. Is this a living one? It appears to be. Hopefully, I can get rid of this spawner pretty quickly, though. My game lagged and I died. That is a huge bummer. I really need a better computer. We had 13 living chests from that. That is such a bummer. Let's see how much gold we're gonna need. My guess is gonna be 68. Okay, 29 is not too bad, I guess. We have 4 currently. And then we had this bounty that we completed that we can go ahead and collect. We can probably submit this. Yeah, we can definitely submit this chromatic iron. This should do it. We'll claim this bad boy up and then let's actually re-roll this bounty right here. What is it gonna be? That's a lot of bronze. So let's put this down and let's open both of these up and see what that brings our total up to. May as well roll this shield up. Oh, we actually got an epic one, which isn't too bad. 18% block chance is pretty huge. Well, that got us 5 more gold. So we're only about 20 away. I think we have one in here as well, don't we? We have 3 in there, actually. But what we're going to do with that is actually make us some more gear because I literally just lost everything that I own. And we're going to roll all this up and hopefully we get something good. Doesn't really look like it. Oh, and they're all tier 1 rolls. Or I guess they're tier 2, but those are horrible. You know, I don't ever listen to you guys, do I? To be fair, that was not my fault. My computer literally froze on me. I think we need to make a wither skeleton farm pretty soon, because afterlife is gonna be a must. But instead of me going into the vault like I normally would right away, I'm gonna work on getting some better gear, some pouches, some swords, and all that good stuff that we're gonna need. But that's gonna have to be tomorrow for me, because to be honest, I'm pretty bummed out about that. But that's not gonna slow us down. That's not gonna stop us. For y'all, this is gonna be instant. Okay, so it's the very next day. I've had some time to think about what I'm gonna do, and believe it or not, it starts with one thing: the jerrys. Basically, what we're gonna do is make a completely new set of gear, like pickaxe and everything, and pretty much treat it like we're never gonna get those items back. So that means a whole new double pouch, and for now, we're only gonna make one. That also means we're gonna need another infinite water bucket. Really kind of blows that we gotta use a pog, but that's just how it goes sometimes. And currently, we have just about everything that we need. I do need to make another magnet, unless I have one in the system, and looks like I may. Okay, nice, I actually do, so that's gonna come in handy. Then we gotta enchant the pickaxe up. Oh, we need 9 levels, and I have 8. That's that Saigey look. Basically, when you need something, and you're just shy of getting it. We're also going to go ahead and put on one of these chip jewels that give us just a bit more mining speed. Oh, and you guys want to know what a bummer is? I have no more coin affinity jewels. So once again, that's just my luck. I'm going to grab a few building blocks from over here at the create base, and we'll throw a few extra inside of our pouch. Okay, and I know I said I was going to treat this like a whole new run to where I wasn't going to get those items back, but I'm not going to make all those upgrades currently because I'm having hopes that we do get our items back. But just in case we don't get our items back right away, I did make a soul flame. We're going to craft this crystal, add a soul flame to it, and hopefully not get a horrible curse. Oh, also this clip is the next day, so I cannot get that knowledge star anymore. Yeah, so let's go ahead and add the soul flame on here. I think this is our first vault running with the soul flame. We are 19 gold short, so I doubt we're gonna get it this vault run, but it's okay. We need to go for living chests and coin piles only, so I'll meet you guys on the other side. Almost forgot my building blocks. I think we're gonna go with pumpkins, seeing as I have a ton. Oh, bummer, we got slowed. That's not the worst curse, though. No, we are not going for the bosses. I'm not gonna get sidetracked. Much as I want to, we're not gonna do it. And let's see how slow this mine's coin piles. Oh, that's not nearly as fast as it was before. I was about to say, did we really only get one coin pile from that? This is gonna take a while. You know what? What the heck? We have afterlife for a reason. We gotta do some crazy things. And there's a living chest right there. We may not even find all the monoliths, but just in case we do, I wanna go ahead and try to fight the bosses because that XP bonus would be a huge plus. All right, that should be all of these guys taken out. Nice. Now back to hunting some coin piles and some living chest. You guys are gonna hate me because I'm not really going for coin piles at this point, but I'm thinking I know that we can get coins from the boss crates. At least I think we can, so maybe that'll make up for the lack of coin piles that we've been finding. Oh, here we go, a couple more coin piles. No, guys, I promise this is not staged. I don't know what my luck is when it comes to dragon rooms whenever I need the coins. We gotta build that pit again, so hopefully we can get all these mobs to not spawn on us. Oh wow, I just looked at my sword and it's nearly broken, so I gotta be super careful about using it. So once again, we're gonna take our little staircase down, and I'll try to show you guys on camera. If it takes too long, I'll edit it out, but I want to at least show you guys how I did it from that last time. So you can probably tell from the timer, this took a lot longer than I wanted it to. But we got the majority of them in there. So I'm gonna go around until I got about 4 minutes left and keep collecting coin piles. It's gonna be a bit slow, so I probably won't get as many as I got the last time. Really missing that coin affinity right about now. Okay, so even though it's a bit slower, this should be pretty satisfying. Oh yeah, check that out. This is probably one of the most satisfying things in Vault Hunters. If only I could do it just a bit quicker. Oh gosh, time's getting pretty low, and I forgot to make a vault compass, so I think I know how to get back home, but not 100% sure. So yeah, I'm gonna go for about 4 minutes left, and then we're gonna start trying to find our way back to the portal. My sword broke, oh no. Oh, that's such a bummer. Oh no, there's a creeper right there. That could have been bad. I also didn't realize how low time was getting, so we're gonna start heading back to the portal and hopefully find our way to it. Okay, I'm seeing some marker blocks. If I'm not mistaken, it should be this very next room, or maybe the one after that. Oh my gosh, home sweet home, here we come. Well, you guys know what time it is. Let's head back to the base and see what kind of loot we got. Only 2,000 experience, but how many coin piles? 395, so a little bit less of that last dragon's lair room that we got. But the real kicker is, I know we got a couple pieces of gold. Yeah, we got 7 this time around. So let's add that to the collection. And time to open up the pouch. That is a lot of bronze. I currently have none in my system, so we'll be able to see an exact amount on how many we got. Oh wow, it's showing we have 1914. So let's start crafting that into a little bit of silver. We did also find 18 from that room. Craft all these up. This may actually be enough to get all of our items back. And if not, we're gonna get pretty close at least. Oh, we got 25. You know what that means. This should be... Oh, it is. It's more than enough to get our items back. So let me clear up my inventory. That means get rid of all of this junk, and then we'll get our items back. It is such a bummer that we lost that sword, because personally, it was probably one of my favorites. But I don't think it can top this sword, so let's click this and let it start spitting out all of our items. Oh, yeah. This is great. Nice. Oh, that's right. We found that unidentified magnet. So let's roll that bad boy up real quick. What are we going to get? It better be something decent, I think. Oh, we got a common magnet with 3.8 range, a little bit of velocity, and that's pretty much it. We can reroll it a bit. That durability would be pretty sick. We'll do the soul shard chance. Wait, what happened to my chest plate and my helmet? Okay, here's a chest plate right there, but I don't think that was the one that we were using. Oh, it feels so good to have this pickaxe back. Okay, so I'm buying a couple items from here, hoping to... Okay, well, I'm pretty much empty. I was hoping to try to get another knowledge star for sale, but it doesn't look like we're going to get lucky this time around. Yeah, so I spent over 750 soul shards, and this is everything that I got, besides the totem and the infinite water bucket. A couple volt diamonds aren't really too bad, though. But what I want to do is craft up as many burgers as I can, because I want to see if we can actually get to level 25 just from burgers. I'm going to start eating these bad boys up, starting with the deluxe burgers, and hopefully we get that level up. Or level ups, I guess. Okay, look at my trash can every time I eat a burger. It moves just a little bit. Almost like I'm throwing the wrapper away from the burger. Oh, we're getting pretty close. I think we're actually going to be able to do it. Oh yeah, we did it, guys. Well, now that we're level 35, let's see what kind of pickaxe we can craft. So we go from chromatic iron, chromatic steel. Is this going to... Oh, it's voltarite. For some reason, I thought it was going to be the black chromatic ingots. We need 12 voltarite ingots and a couple of volt gold. And these really aren't too expensive to craft. I might actually go with this recipe right here. Oh, we need more chromatic iron. Luckily, I know where I have just a bit. Should be over here, right next to Harold. Oh, remember I told you guys last episode that the comments would be back. Okay, it turns out we do not have any chromatic iron over here. Okay, we have 4 blocks. That should be more than enough. Oh, that reminds me, this Saturday, we're going to be doing a live stream around 9 p.m. Central Standard Time. Oh my gosh, I'm missing the netherite. I have 1 ancient debris, and I'm going to have to go mining for another one. So I'll see you guys in about 10 hours. But when mining for ancient debris, I always come down to like Y level 15. Just because a long time ago, I saw a video that it's like the best place to find it, and I haven't had any problems with it yet, so hopefully we find one rather quickly. So the worst part is always coming next to this gravel. Oh, okay. That's pretty nice. Our hallway, I don't know if you guys can see it, but that little melon right there, yeah, we're not really too far. No shot, this was a 2 vein. That's insane. Wait a minute, there was 3 right there? Oh my gosh. Well, 10 hours turned into about 10 seconds. It's literally going to take me longer to get to my portal than it did to find the ancient debris. But now all I gotta do is smelt this up in my diamond furnace, right after I take a nap. Actually, can you smoke these things in here? Oh, nice, you can. Come on, where's the next one? That's all we need right there, and we can now make this new pickaxe. Oh my gosh, I'm super excited because we have so many jewels that we can add to this thing. Bam, bam, scroll on down. Here we go. Nice. Wait, is there a huge difference between these things? The mining speed's the same, the durability... Oh, you know what? I guess it has a better capacity, and it looks like it has... That's about it. One extra repair slot. So I really want to get another coin affinity, but we'll hold on to this pickaxe for that. What I'm going to do is get all of these things right here, like the Gilded Affinity, the Ornate Affinity, the Living Affinity, maybe the item quantity, and I think we're going to do Soulbound. That's going to be like a must. I'm so tempted on using this one, but I just don't think it's the right move because it's 58 size versus a 13 size. Yeah, I get a little bit more item rarity, but currently not worth it. I still don't know what this Vanilla Immortality does. We should start using anvils as our marker block, but for now, we're going to place this one right here, and we're going to start adding all of these jewels. We got the mining speed. We got the... Oh, wait. We have the soul bound. Now we have the mining speed. We're going to put some living affinity on there. We're going to put some ornate. Can't forget the gilded. And all I'm missing now, this is like a stacked pickaxe, and we still have 121 slots. Basically, all I need is a coin and wooden chest, and then we have an omega pickaxe. Basically, an atomic dissimilar. I'm going to get some emeralds. I'm going to get some books, and we're going to get all the enchants that we need because I don't think, yeah. All right, are you guys ready? We have efficiency, unbreaking, and silk touch. We have our omega pickaxe. Let's put this bed. Oh, we're a couple levels short. Nothing a few bottles of enchanting can't fix. Bottles of enchanting over. And just like that, we are level 15. We can put on this, and you already know what time it is. It's time to add some comments to the comment wall. So we did do a live stream this recent Saturday, and I said insane a lot, so I had to choose this comment. It's from Ovid. Sorry if I'm mispronouncing that. Just as promised, I have counted every insane said in the secret live stream, and we got a total of 65. I double checked both with manual counting and by checking the transcripts on the live stream. That is absolutely insane. I had no idea I said it that much. One might say it's insane. No, but I really do appreciate you counting each and every insane. You're a total madman. And then up next we have Am200H2. If you enchant a bubble blur with stasis, you can create temporary bubble blocks to walk on. This was one of very many comments that actually commented that, but I think this one was the first one too, so we went ahead and added them to the wall. This wall is getting super full. By the way, if I haven't added you to the wall, be sure to comment down below letting me know I haven't added you, and I'll make sure to get you in one of these upcoming episodes. But this is going to probably do it for today's episode, guys. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. I'm super sorry it took so long to get it out. Like I said earlier, just been super, super busy. Anyways, I hope you guys have a great day. God bless you guys. Bye-bye. Thank you once again, Graham. I really appreciate it.